All right, Algebra 1B students, welcome to part 2 of lesson 11.3 on dividing polynomials. Today we are actually going to divide polynomials by binomials. So in order to do that, we're going to use the long division method that we used to use when we divided large numbers.
Please come down.
So let's review that long division method before we actually get into doing this with polynomials, with x's and y's and things like that. Let's just review this process of long division that we're talking about here. If I were to ask you to divide 347 divided by 24 by hand, the first thing we do is look at the number we're dividing by and see how many times it goes into this first number here, the 3. Well, obviously 24 doesn't go into 3 at all, so I just put an x up there. There's nothing there. Right? It's not there. Then I take the first two numbers, because it didn't go into the first number, I have to take the first two numbers. So now it's 24 into 34, and that's one time. It goes in there one time. Okay. So once we know that it goes into that number one time, we take this number and multiply it by this number times. 1 times 24 is 24, and then we subtract here, and that's 10, and we bring down the 7, so it's 107. Okay, we bring down the 7. So then we ask ourselves the next question, how many times does 24 go into 107? And the answer there is 4 times. And then we do this again. We multiply the 4 times the 24, and that gives us 96. Then we subtract the 107 and the 96 like we did the 34 and the 24. 107 minus 96 is 11, but I don't have any more numbers to bring down here, so I have a remainder of 11. So the answer is 14 with a remainder of 11. Okay? 14 with a remainder of 11. When I run out of stuff to pull down, that's what I have. That's what my remainder is, what I got when I subtracted those two numbers. So that's the process that we're going to go through when we divide polynomials as well. Hopefully it makes sense. You should be able to see the transition very well from here to this type of problem. Okay? The process of dividing a polynomial by a binomial is very similar to what we just did. You will write the answer like this. It will be all of your stuff, your quotient, plus, and then your remainder goes on top of a fraction with the stuff you are dividing by on the bottom of the fraction. So divisor means the stuff I'm dividing by. Okay, and I'll show you what that looks like here in this example. If I were to divide 3d squared minus 4d plus 13 by d plus 3, the first thing that I do is I look to see how many times does this term go into that term. So really it's all about the first term here, the d. So it goes into that term, so d times what really is what I'm asking. D times what will give me the 3d squared? And the answer is, well, 3d, because d times 3d is 3d to the second power. So that's the first term of my answer. Then I multiply, as I did previously, I multiply this term by, now I have to multiply by all of this, okay, by d plus 3. And that gives me 3d squared, right? 3d times d, I just did that. Plus, now it's 3d times the 3, which gives me plus 9. So I found d times what gave me 3d squared, put that on top, and then multiplied it by each of the two pieces of what I'm dividing by, the d and the 3. Okay? And so I have, excuse me, this is 9d. cavity. So 3D times 3 is 9D. Still a D there. And now I subtract. Okay. Now I subtract. So the minus 3D squared minus 3D squared will be nothing. Negative 4D minus 9D gives me negative 13D. Okay. And now I bring down, obviously, my plus 13. So now I ask the question, okay, how many times does D go into this term? Or D times what will give me the negative 13D? And the answer is minus 13. Negative 13. So now that I have the second term of my answer, or my quotient piece, I'm going to take the negative 13 and multiply that by D plus 3. So I take the 13, and I multiply it by the D, and I multiply it by the 3. So negative 13 times D is negative 13D. That's good. I've designed it like this. And then negative 13 times 3 is negative 39. So one more time, I'm going to subtract. Negative 13D minus negative 13D, they're the same, so they go away. Positive 13 minus negative 39 gives me positive, because this is like adding a positive now, right? It gives me a positive 52. Okay? But I no longer have anything to pull down from right here. So my remainder is 52. And as I said before, we write our answer like a quotient plus. Once you've run out of terms to pull down, you put a plus sign, then write your remainder, 52, and make that the top of a fraction, with the bottom of a fraction being D plus 3, because that is what I started. Okay. So my final answer for this division is this. 3D minus 13 plus 52 over D plus 3. So it's all about figuring out D times what gets me to all of these pieces, multiply, distribute, and subtract. Okay? Let's look at one more. Here we're dividing 2m squared minus m minus 3 by m plus 1. So the first question I will ask myself is, m times what gives me the 2m squared? The correct answer there is 2m. M times 2m is 2m squared. Okay? So now I'm going to take 2m and multiply it by m plus 1. I'm going to take this and times it by all of this stuff here. 2m times m gives me the 2m squared that I wanted. 2m times 1 gives me a plus 2m. Okay? And now I will subtract. 2m squared minus 2m squared is gone. Negative m minus 2 more m's is negative 3m. Okay. And now I am going to bring down this negative 3 right here. Bring down the negative 3. And now I'm going to ask, okay, m times what gets me to that negative 3? And the answer is obvious, or sorry, gets me to negative 3m, and the answer is negative 3. And the answer here is negative 3. And then if I multiply the negative 3 times m plus 1, that's what I'm going to put underneath here, over there, and then subtract and see what my remainder is going to be, because I'm officially out of numbers to pull down here. So negative 3 times m gives me the negative 3m that I wanted. Negative 3 times 1 gives me a minus 3. But now when I subtract, what I want you to notice is these two are exactly the same. Negative 3 minus negative 3 is gone. Nothing. Negative 3 minus negative 3 is another nothing. So my remainder is actually 0. So you can put plus 0 over m plus 1, because my remainder was nothing, because these two things here, here, and here ended up being exactly the same. Or you can just leave that off totally. You don't have to write that. My final answer here, I would love your final answer to be this. 2m minus 3. That's what I get when I divide 2m squared minus m minus 3 by m plus 1. Okay? Now, I would like you to try one of these on your own. I would like you to try dividing 20c squared plus 23c minus 7 divided by c minus 1. So follow the same process again. And when you're done, come on back and I'll show you what we should get. So pause the video here, take a look at this problem, and see what you get. Okay, we should get 20c there, and this is 20c squared minus 20c, so this really becomes minus negative 43c, and then bring down minus 7, so this becomes minus 43. Plus 43, so this is 43c minus 43, and I subtract negative 7 minus negative 43, that becomes a positive 36, so I add 36 over c minus 4. 20c plus 43 plus 36 over c minus 1. If you have questions about this process, please, 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 please ask in class tomorrow while you are working on your practice problem set. Otherwise, that is all I have for you tonight. Long division of polynomials. Have a wonderful night.